现在有没有声音
？OK 了，
请我们一同打开《加拉太书》第五章。
Let's turn our Bible to Galatians chapter 5.
我们今天要读第十三节到第十五节。
We will read verse 13 to verse 15.
无论你是用英文还是中文
，Whether you read in English or Chinese.
我们都一起来把这几节圣经读一遍。
Let's read through all together.
十三节，弟兄们，你们蒙召是要得自由，只是不可将你们的自由当作放纵情欲的机会，总要用爱心互相服侍。因为全律法都包在爱人如己这一句话之内了。你们要谨慎，若相咬相吞，只怕要彼此消灭了。我们在主面前再有一点点的祷告。
Let's have some prayer before the Lord.
亲爱的主，我们满心的感谢赞美你。
Dear Lord, we are so grateful and we praise you.
是你极大的恩典。
It is your grace.
我们可以脱离罪恶，成为你的孩子。
So that we can be free from sin and become your children.
我们可以活在你的家中。
And we may live in your family.
我们也可以常常跟弟兄姐妹一起到你的脚前来敬拜你。
And we can worship you before your feet together with brothers and sisters.
虽然因着疫情
Although because of the pandemic,
我们不能够面对面的相聚
We cannot gather face in face.
但是靠着你给我们的科技
But through this technology you have given us,
我们在灵的里面，我们实实在在的是一同聚在你的脚前。
But in spirit, we're truly gathered before your feet in spirit.
并且我们也真实的相信你就在我们的中间。
And we also truly believe that you are among us.
因为你在这里。
Just because you are here.
在我们中间就有爱。
So that there is love in us.
又有光。
There's a light in us too.
就有生命。
And we also have life.
我们求你悦纳你百姓在你面前一切的敬拜。
We ask you that you accept all the praise and worship from your people.
我们也求你把你自己的恩惠慈爱借着你的话语向我们解开。
And we also ask you that you open your words so that you can grant us your mercy and grace.
但愿你的百姓在你话语的光中可以见光。
And we ask that your people will see light through the light of your words.
我们祷告是奉主耶稣基督宝贝的名。
We pray in the precious name of Jesus Christ.
Amen. 在美国做家长的人，家里的小孩子到了大约两岁的时候。
If you are parents in the U.S., when your children reach the age of two,
你就会常常听到别人跟你说，哎呀，你的孩子现在是在 terrible two。恐怖的两岁啊。
And you will often hear people say to you, wow, your children are in terrible too.
为什么叫做恐怖的两岁呢？
Why is it called terrible too?
因为两岁的孩子啊，他就非常的要自由。
Because the children, when they're at the age of two, they so want freedom.
而且他已经开始有能力去执行他所要的自由。
And they actually have some capability of realizing his freedom.
而且他认为他想做什么他就可以做什么。
And he thinks he can do whatever he wants.
可是他并不知道。
But he doesn't really know.
他想做的很多的事他不一定能做。
The many things that he wants to do, that he shouldn't really do.
他也不知道他要做的那些事如果真的做了那个后果会怎么样。
And he won't understand the consequences of the things he wants to do.
不只是恐怖两岁的小孩不懂什么叫自由。
And not only those terrible two children don't understand what freedom means.
其实很多年轻人何尝不是如此呢？
The many teenagers are also like that.
我碰到很多的年轻的人看到他喜欢的男孩子或者是女孩子的时候。
I met so many young people when they see the girls or the boys they like.
哎呀，荷尔蒙在他身上一发动。
And the hormones in his body is activated.
这个时候他就拼了命要他的自由啊。
And he will fight for death, fight until death to, for his freedom.
我不知道听到有多少人跟我抗议。
I've heard so many times that people complain to me.
为什么教会啊，要提醒我们啊，不可以单独的跟异性花很多时间在一起呢？
Why the church always nagging us that we shouldn't stay alone with someone who is the opposite sex?
我们有自由啊。
We have the freedom to do that.
甚至有人还告诉我。
Even someone told me.
这个匈牙利的诗人啊。
And a Hungarian poet.
这个 Sandro 曾经做的一首诗。
Sandro, he made us a short poem.
生命诚可贵啊。
Life is dear.
爱情价更高啊。
Love is dearer.
若为自由故。两者皆可抛
啊。Both can be given up just for freedom.
自由。
Freedom.
到底什么是自由？
What is that?
美国以前的总统Franklin罗斯福
The U.S. President Franklin Roosevelt.
他在1941年的时候
In 1941.
他宣告
He proclaimed.
世界各地的人都应该享受四种自由
People from all over the world should be entitled with four types of freedom.
言论自由敬拜自由
The freedom of speech. The freedom worship.
免于匮乏的自由和免于恐惧的自由。
A freedom from want and freedom from fear.
我说还好啊。
I said it is good.
罗斯福没有说我们也可以自由的谈恋爱。
He didn't say we can date freely.
我喜欢跟谁谈恋爱就跟谁谈恋爱。
I can date whoever I want.
管他有没有结过婚。
It doesn't matter if she's married or not.
我喜欢跟几个人一起谈就跟几个人一起谈。
And I can choose to date with a multiple subject.
你不要笑。
And don't laugh at him.
其实后现代人的自由不就是这样吗？
It is just to the people from the postmodern world.
我喜欢干什么，我就要干什么。
I should be able to do whatever I like to do.
你也不要干涉我。
Don't interfere with what I do.
其实每一个人的心里面都很了解自由是非常宝贵的。
We all know that freedom is very precious.
很重要的。
It is very important.
一个人没有自由其实他真的是不是人了。
Without freedom,A human is not a human.
但是自由不是没有限制的。
But freedom is not without limits.
自由也不是没有责任的。
Freedom is not without responsibility.
没有限制、没有责任的自由一定就是灾难。
A freedom without responsibility and limit is a disaster.
其实想一想。
So think about it.
火车受铁轨限制的时候，其实是火车最自由的时候。
when the train is limited by the railways, it is the most freedom time the train has.
一个开车的人最自由的时候是他遵守所有的交通规则的时候。
When someone who follows the traffic law, he has the most freedom to drive.
那圣经里面告诉我们自由是怎么回事呢？
So what does the Bible teach us about freedom?
读圣经的人都知道加拉太书是基督徒的自由大宪章。
Some Bible scholars consider the book of Galatians as the great constitution of Christians.
那特别是第五章的一到十五节。
Especially the verse 1 to 15 of chapter 5.
它告诉我们神给我们的自由有一些重要的特点。
It tells us there are a few important points about the freedom that's granted by God.
第一个特点。
The first one.
自由是神给的。
Freedom is granted by God.
第二个特点。
Second.
自由最大的仇敌是肉体。
The greatest enemy of freedom is flesh.
第三个特点。
The third.
自由是为了彰显神的爱。
The purpose of freedom is to manifest the love of God.
如果我们还记得我们在读第五章第一节的时候。
If we still remember when we read chapter 5 verse 1.
那里告诉我们基督释放了我们叫我们得以自由。
Paul tells us for freedom,Christ has set us free.
那里说神为这自由要释放我们叫我们可以得着自由。
It says, for the purpose of having a freedom, God has set us free for us to get the freedom.
直白一点的说
frankly speaking,
就是神拯救我们最重要的目的是让我们活得自由。
The most important purpose of God saving us is for us to live freely.
然后保罗花了十二节的圣经。
And for the next 12 verses,
保罗告诉我们要怎么珍惜我们这个自由。
Paul tells us how to treasure this great freedom.
千万不要做律法主义的奴仆。
Under no circumstances, don't become a slave of legalism.
千万不要做一个把次要当主要的那种人。
And don't become a person who major in minor.
我们要能够自由的奔跑来享受神儿子的丰富。
We should be able to run freely so that we can appreciate the abundance in the sonship.
那今天我们读的第十三节。
And the verse 13 we just read today.
他一开始就说。
It says in the beginning.
弟兄们，你们蒙召是要得自由。
For brothers, you were called to freedom.
神救我们是要我们得自由。
God saves us for us to have freedom.
神呼召我们还是叫我们得自由。
And also God called us still for us to have freedom.
神呼召我们是叫我们能够自由的爱。
God called us for us to have a freedom to love freely and willingly.
能够成全神在我们生命中的旨意。
So the will of God will be accomplished in our lives.
主耶稣曾经说过。
Lord Jesus once said,
所以天父的儿子叫你们自由，你们就真自由了。
If the Son sets you free, you will be free indeed.
这是约翰福音八章三十六节所告诉我们的。
This is what was recorded in Gospel John chapter 8 verse 36.
所以自由是神所赐给我们宝贵的礼物。
So, freedom is a great and precious gift granted by God.
自由是基督徒与生俱来的权利。
And it's also a birthright for Christians.
这是为什么基督徒一定要珍惜神给我们的自由。
This is why all Christians should value and treasure the freedom that's granted by God.
那同时我们也要尊重神给别人的自由。
And at the same time, we should respect the freedom God has given to the others.
然后第十三节的接下去。
And then in verse 13,
他说我们不可以用神所给我们的自由来满足我们的肉体。
It says, do not use your freedom as an opportunity for the flesh.
你知道自由它有一个最大的仇敌就是肉体。
And you know that the greatest enemy of freedom is flesh.
那十三节的第二句话说只是不可将你们的自由当作放纵肉体的机会。
And the second part of verse 13 says, only do not use your freedom as an opportunity for the flesh.
那你注意我故意不用中文和合本的情欲这两个字。
And please notice that I purposely did not use the word lust that's mentioned in a Chinese translation.
因为在希腊文中间这一个原文的字是 SARS。
Because this word in the original language, it's SARS.
那 SARS 在英文圣经里面基本上没有翻译过是 lust, 情欲这个词。
And this word was rarely translated into lust in English versions.
那像在NIV 的翻译里面是翻作犯罪的本性。
NIV translates the word into the sinful nature.
那大部分其他的英文版本
And for most other English translations,
有的翻作肉体
is translated into carnal.
有的翻作血气
or flesh.Our nature.
它主要的意义
It's emphasized the meaning.
就是一切不出于神的不属灵的那个部分都叫做 SARS.
Yeah, its meaning emphasizes on anything that is not from God, not spiritual.
那所以我比较喜欢用肉体这个词
So I like to use the word flesh.
只是不可将你们的自由当作放纵肉体的机会。
Only do not use your freedom as an opportunity for the flesh.
在福音的恩典里面
In the grace from the gospel,
神给了我们自由。
God has given us freedom.
那保罗告诉我们，绝对不能够把神给我们这么宝贵的自由拿来用作放纵肉体的机会。
So Paul reminds us, do not use this freedom as an opportunity for us to indulge in ourselves.
放纵这个词原来是一个军事用语。
The word indulgence in the original language is a military terminology.
是讲到在军事的阵地里面有了一个破口。
That means in a military march position, there is a breaking point.
那意思就是我们不能够放纵我们的肉体这样子的一个破口成为别人对我们属灵的攻击。
That means we cannot allow sin to become a breaking point so that we are attacked spiritually from our enemies.
基督徒是脱离了律法主义的捆绑。
Christians are free from the bondage of legalism.
但是我们不能够把我们脱离了律法就当作我们满足自己肉体的一个机会。
But we should not use it as an excuse or opportunity to satisfy our flesh.
那在教会历史里面一直就有这些人。
But in church history, there are always people like these.
既然我们得到了神自由的恩典。
So if we have received the grace of freedom,
我们做好做不好不会影响神对我们的爱。
So it doesn't matter if we do good deeds or bad deeds, it is not going to impact the love of God towards us.
那犯罪有什么关系呢?
Then it doesn't really matter if we sin or not.
那体贴肉体有什么问题呢?
It doesn't really matter if we satisfy our flesh.
既然神在基督里都接纳我了,
So if God have already accepted me in Christ,
我就放纵肉体吧。
So I should really satisfy myself and indulge in myself.
那我听过最离谱的异端的教导。
I have heard some most heretical teaching from a cult.
他们是根据罗马书五章二十节。
And it is actually according to the book of Romans, chapter 5, verse 20.
律法本是外天的教，过犯显多。
The law came in to increase the trespass.
只是罪在哪里显多，恩典就更显多了。
But where sin increased, grace abounded all the more.
所以他们就说了。
So they say.
看到没有?
See?
你希望恩典在你的生命中更多一点吗?
Do you want more grace in your life?
多犯罪啊。
So commit more sin.
因为罪在哪里显多，恩典就更显多了。
If you, the more sin you commit, the more grace you will receive.
这些人完全不明白。
These people have no idea.
真正的自由不是任意犯罪，满足肉体。
The true freedom is not for you to sin freely and to satisfy your flesh.
真正的自由是有不犯罪的自由。
The true freedom is for you not to sin.
因为约翰福音八章三十四节那里清楚地告诉我们
Because John chapter 8 verse 34 says
我实实在在地告诉你们所有犯罪的就是罪的奴仆
I verily, verily tell you for those who sin are the slaves of sin
所以犯罪的绝对不是自由
So if you sin, it is not really freedom
你是奴仆。
You are a slave.
满足肉体就是肉体的奴隶。
If you satisfy your flesh, then you are the slave of your flesh.
真正的自由是在基督里神已经释放了我们。
The true freedom is from the breaking of the bondage of sin by Christ.
我以前有一个朋友。
I had a friend before.
他没有信主的时候。
Before he became a Christian.
他就很喜欢来参加我们的聚会。
He likes to come to our fellowship a lot.
但是呢，你每次到了关键时刻问他怎么样，要不要信啊？
But every time when I ask him, do you want to believe in Jesus?
他说不要，不要，不要，不要。
He always hesitated.
为什么？
Why?
他说信了耶稣就不自由咯。
He told me that I will lose my freedom if I believe in Jesus.
我说你怕失去什么自由啊?
So ask him, what type of freedom are you afraid of losing?
他你又不是不知道我就是爱抽烟嘛。
He told me, you know that. I just like to smoking cigarettes.
那么信了耶稣我就不能抽烟了这怎么行啊?
If I believe in Jesus, I won't be able to smoke anymore.
我就告诉他。
Therefore, I told him.
我说圣经里面没有写信耶稣就不可以抽烟呢。
The Bible never says you cannot smoke cigarette after believing Jesus.
还有这种事。
He said, how so?
我说圣经里面没有写信耶稣不可以抽烟。
I told him once more,The Bible does not say you cannot smoke cigarettes.
那你们为什么信耶稣都不抽烟呢?
But then he asked, why don't you smoke cigarettes?
我说我们信耶稣的人有抽烟的自由。
So I told him, we actually do have freedom to smoke cigarettes.
但是我们比你更幸福的地方是我们也有不抽烟的自由。
But more fortunately,We also have a freedom not to smoke cigarettes.
我说你根本没有自由啊。
I said, you actually don't have freedom.
你是烟的奴仆。
You are a slave of your cigarettes.
你是没有自由不抽烟的。
You don't have a freedom not to smoke.
我说不抽烟不会死吧。
If you don't smoke, you won't die, right?
啊，对啊。
He said yes.
但是他下面加一句。
But he also added another, one more word.
那比死还难受。
It is worse than death.
所以不抽烟的自由是很宝贵的自由。
So the freedom of not want to smoke is a precious freedom.
后来神的恩典临到我这个朋友。
And later on, God's grace came upon him.
后来他真的信了主了。
He truly believed in the Lord.
然后很奇怪的，他就失去了烟瘾。
And amazingly, he was not addicted into cigarettes anymore.
后来他有一天告诉我。
And later one day he told me.
哎，他说这个不抽烟的自由太好了。
The freedom of not smoking is so good.
然后他跟我讲了一大堆不抽烟的好处。
And he told me all kinds of benefits of not smoking cigarettes.
这是真的自由。
And this is the true freedom.
如果我们放纵肉体。
If we indulge ourselves, indulge in our flesh.
那我们就失去了自由。
Then we lose our freedom completely.
所以这个肉体不但会夺取我们的自由。
So the flesh will deprive our freedom.
更可怕的是在第十五节。
The more terrible reason is in verse 15.
这个肉体啊，会带来非常可怕的伤害和毁灭。
Flesh will bring forth horrible hurt and destruction.
十五节这样说。
Verse 15 says,
你们要谨慎。
Watch out.
若相咬相吞，只怕要彼此消灭了。
If you bite and devour one another, and you are consumed by one another.
一个放纵肉体的人。
For someone who indulged himself.
其实就是一个自私以自我为中心的人。
He is just a person who is selfish and self-centered.
那这样的人呢？
For a person like this,
他的特点就是骄傲和自私。
He is always having pride and selfishness.
那一个骄傲自私在哪里？
And wherever there is pride and selfishness,
哪里就一定有争吵、有纷争、有辩论、有不和睦。
There must be quarrels and fightings and debating and bad relationships.
所以肉体是会把我们带到极大的毁灭中。
So, flesh will lead us into a great destruction.
我举个例子。
Let me give an example.
假如我是一个放纵肉体的人。
If I am someone who is selfish and indulging myself.
我一定里面充满的就是骄傲和自私。
I must be filled with selfishness and pride.
那我到教会里左看看右看看，这个人也有毛病，那个人我也不顺眼。
Then if I go to church, I will always find someone whom I don't like.
那一个骄傲自私的人，他就是我就可以用我的自由啊。
So for someone who has pride and selfishness, I can use my freedom.
我看你不顺眼，我就给你脸色看。
If I don't like you, I will show this guy a poker face.
我甚至于可以说一些话来回报你。
I can do some gossip behind this person.
我可以藐视羞辱你。
I can mock you, I can demise you.
我到小组查经的时候。
And if I go to a Bible study fellowship.
管你我懂不懂啊。
It doesn't matter if I know the Bible or not.
反正我要用我的自由，我抓到机会我就拼命发表，拼命讲。
And I would just use my freedom to use all the opportunities to speak.
一个骄傲自私的人。
For someone who has pride and selfishness.
那肯定又是一个叛逆的人。
Is also someone who is disobedient.
所以我如果这样子的一个人，我到教会里我一定是说，哎呀，这个，这你们教会这些负责人，他们懂什么呀？
if a person like me goes to a church, I will think those responsible brothers, they don't really know much.
他们这些年轻人能够搞出什么名堂?
These people are too young. They can't do much.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹,
dear brothers and sisters,
你想一想,
so think about it.
肉体一定会带出别人的肉体。
Flesh will lead out other people's flesh.
如果我把这样的肉体带到教会里面,
if I bring this type of flesh into a church,
那一定就会有人同意我。
Someone will agree with me.
那一定有人反对我。
And someone will also disagree with me.
然后就开始你分门结党。
And eventually people will split.
然后就最后就落到保罗形容加拉太人的光景。
And eventually it will become something like Paul describes the Galatians.
相咬相吞。
They bite and devour.
这个保罗用这个咬和吞这个两个字。
The two verbs bite and devour that Paul uses.
其实就是来描写一群野兽那种凶残的行为。
They are to describe those cruel actions from wild beasts.
所以自由最大的仇敌是肉体。
So the greatest enemy of freedom is flesh.
而且肉体不但会夺取我们的自由。
And not only flesh will deprive our freedom,
肉体会带来团契和教会的分裂和毁灭。
It will bring death and destruction of Christian testimony and fellowship.
那第13节最后那一段,
and the last part of verse 13,
以及第14节,
and also verse 14,
是告诉我们自由是为了彰显神的爱。
They tell us the purpose of freedom is for us to manifest the love of God.
总要用爱心互相服侍。
Through love, serve one another.
这里用爱心互相服侍原文的意思就是彼此成为爱的奴仆。
The original meaning of through love, serve one another is to become a slave of love to each other.
保罗在这章圣经里面已经讲过两种不同的奴仆。
In chapter 5, Paul already mentioned two types of slaves.
一种是做肉体情欲的奴仆。
One is a slave of a lust of flesh.
那这种人我们称他为叫放纵主义。
And this is just self-indulgence.
那另外一种人是做律法的奴仆。
Another type of slave is the slave of law.
那我们称他们为律法主义。
And this is called legalism.
那一个人只要是这两种的奴仆。
So either way, if you're a slave of these two types of legalism and self-indulgence,
你就不可能有爱的自由。
And then it is impossible for you to have a freedom of love.
让我解释为什么。
Let me explain why.
因为如果是一个律法主义者,
so if you're a person that is legalism,
你是律法的奴隶。
You are a slave of law.
一个律法的奴隶啊,
a slave of law.
他所关心的我是怎么把律法守好。
All I care is to how to obey the law well.
那我为什么很关心要把律法守好呢?
Now why do we care this?
因为我把律法守好了,别人就会看得起我,神就会更多的祝福我。
So if I obey the law good enough, I will earn people's respect by the good deeds of obeying the law.
他并不是为着别人的好处去遵守律法。
He is not to obey the law for other people's benefit.
一个律法主义者遵守的律法,其实他的动机还是自私,还是为着满足他的肉体。
The root cause or the motivation of a person who has legalism is just to satisfy himself.
同样的一个放纵主义者,
in the same principle for people who is self-indulgent.
啊，他做的一切事情都是要满足自己的肉体。
He does everything to satisfy his own flesh.
他更不会考虑到别人的感受。
He will not consider other people's feeling at all.
哪怕他是在服侍别人的时候，他是要借着服侍来满足自己。
Even though he is serving others, he is still trying to satisfy himself through serving others.
所以放纵主义它的源头也是肉体。
So the root cause of a person who is self-indulgent is also his flesh.
这两种人
For these two type of people,
他们是没有办法自由的去爱的。
There's no way for them to freely and willingly to love.
他们更不可能成为一个爱的奴仆。
They by no means will become a slave of love.
那在现实生活中我们怎么样用爱心互相服侍呢？
Therefore, in our daily lives, how should we realize this serve one another through love?
马丁路德说得很好。
Martin Luther once said,
他说要做爱的奴隶很简单。
So it is actually quite simple to become a slave of love.
就是做一些微不足道的事。
Just to do something small.
教导犯错误的。
For example, to teach someone who made a mistake.
安慰受苦的。
To comfort someone who is in suffering.
鼓励软弱的。
To encourage someone who is weak.
尽可能帮助别人。
Or...try our best to help someone else.
忍受一些不公平的对待。
To tolerate people being mean and unfair.
顺服掌权的。
Obey your authority.
尊敬父母。
Honor your parents.
我觉得他最有趣的是说忍耐喜怒无常的妻子。
And the most interesting is to tolerate your emotional wife.
我不相信所有的妻子都是喜怒无常。
I don't believe that all wives are emotional.
但是马丁路德他认为。
But that this is what he thinks.
这里我们看到一个非常诡调的事情。
And here we see something very paradoxical.
福音是释放我们，叫我们得自由。
The purpose of gospel.Is to set us free so that we can have freedom.
但是我们要用我们的自由去做奴仆。
But how can we use our freedom to become a slave again?
那这个诡调对着基督徒而言并不难理解。
But for Christians, this paradox is not that hard to understand.
因为主耶稣他一辈子的故事就是在这个诡调之中。
For the entire story of Lord Jesus Christ,It's just like this paradox.
一个人要得到生命，就要先失去生命。
If you want to have life, you have to lose life first.
一个升高就要从降卑开始。
If you want to be raised, you have to lower yourself.
最伟大的能力是出自于完全的无能。
The greatest power comes from powerless.
最大的羞辱是十字架。
Greatest mockery is the cross.
而就是十字架带来了最大的荣耀。
But just the cross brings forth the great glory.
基督的一生就是一个诡调。
The whole life of Christ is this paradox.
当耶稣基督在给门徒洗脚的时候。
When Jesus Christ was washing the feet of disciples,
那是一个何等清楚的一幅图画。
This is such a clear image.
他知道他是谁。
He knows who he is.
他不只是他们的主。
He is not only their Lord.
他是万王之王，万主之主。
He is the King of all kings and the Lord of all lords.
然而他却做了罪人的奴仆。
However, he has become a slave of sinners.
好像腓立比书第二章那里说的。
It's just like Philippians chapter 2.
不以自己与神同等为强夺，反倒虚己，取了奴仆的形象。
Though he was in the form of God, it did not count equality with God a thing to be grasped.
我们每一个信主的人，
For every each one of us who are Christian,
神也呼召我们甘愿的成为像主这样的奴仆。
God also called every one of us to become someone who's like our Lord.
最令人惊讶的部分，
The most amazing part
是当我们用我们的自由选择了不自由的时候，
is when we use our freedom to choose not to free.
我们才得到了真正的自由。
Then we actually have the true freedom.
我们才能够享受这个真自由带来的一切的丰满。
Then we can enjoy and appreciate all the abundance that brought forth by this true freedom.
我们可以用基督的爱去服侍别人。
We can use Christ's love to serve others.
我们可以彰显神的爱。
And we can manifest the love of God.
我讲我自己的故事。
Let me tell you my own story.
你们中间很多人都知道。
Many of you know.
当年我追求阿姨是多么的艰难。
It was so hard, when I pursued, Auntie Linda.
因为什么人都反对。
Because all people around me oppose our relationship.
千辛万苦。
And through all trials and difficulties.
好不容易两个人终于结婚了。
Eventually, we got married.
两个相爱的人应该从此快快乐乐过日子咯。
It is supposed to be that we should live happily forever.
但是想也想不到一个吃辣椒的湖南人跟一个吃大蒜的山东人要在一起好好过日子有这么难。
I never thought that it was so difficult for someone who likes to eat pepper and for another for someone who like to eat garlic to live together and have a good life.
经过一次又一次的矛盾啊，吵架啊，痛苦啊，伤害啊。
There are so many times of conflicts, arguing and painful conflicts.
看着他又想要自杀，又想要离婚的。
He once tried to commit suicide and we also almost got divorced.
心都碎了。
My heart was so broken.
啊，我多少次跟自己讲，以后再也不要惹他生气了。
For so many times, I have made up my mind not to agitate him again, agitate her again.
一定要好好珍惜他。
I should really treasure this love relationship.
但是因为我不是一个做奴仆的人。
It's just because I am not a slave.
其实我是我肉体的奴仆。
I am a slave of my own flesh.
所以等一到事情来的时候
So even for a small matter
我里面的自私和骄傲就一定跑出来
The pride and selfishness in me will come out
就会伤害我所爱的人
They will hurt someone who love
而且我还觉得我说的是对的我做的是对的
And at the same time, strangely, I think what I said is right
我深深地尝到了没有自由去爱的痛苦。
I suffered this love without freedom.
不是不想爱。
It is not that I don't want to love.
不是不爱。
It is not that I don't have love.
是没有自由。
It's that I don't have this freedom.
直到有一天。
Until one day.
神真让我看到了耶稣的爱。
God let me see the love of Christ.
他愿意做奴仆。
He is willing to become a slave.
我被神的爱感动。
I was touched by the love of God.
我也愿意做奴仆。
Then I was willing to become a slave.
等我真的愿意做奴仆以后
When I truly want to become a slave
非常奇妙
Very interesting, amazingly.
有很多麻烦事发生的时候,
when some circumstances happens,
神就让我想起来我是个奴仆。
God will remind us that I am a slave.
跟奴仆是不会发脾气的。
For a slave, slaves don't really get angry.
一个奴仆是不需要为自己辩护的。
A slave don't have to defend for himself.
一个奴仆不需要跟别人讲道理的。
For a slave, he don't have to argue or reason with others.
因为你一切的事情是你的主人在负责。
For your master is responsible for everything in your life.
非常奇妙。
This is so amazing.
当我什么时候认定我是奴仆的身份的时候
，Whenever I acknowledge my identity of a slave，
我就有自由去爱。
Then I suddenly have a freedom to love。
就是有一些很难爱的场景里面，我都可以开开心心的爱。
Even for those very difficult situations, I could still love freely。
这个原则。
This principle
不只是在夫妻之间
does not only apply in marriage
父母儿女中间
between parents and children
婆媳之间
between mother-in-laws and daughter-in-laws
教会的弟兄姐妹之间
even between brothers and sisters in church
都是这样
it's the same principle
你希望享受爱的自由
if you want toenjoy or appreciate the freedom of love.
你就要用神给你的自由选择去做奴仆。
You have to choose to become a freedom using the freedom. You have to use the freedom to choose to become a slave.
如果你想要满足你自己的肉体,
if you want to satisfy your own flesh,
你就继续活在痛苦中。
And you will still live in suffering and pain.
因为全律法都包在爱人如己这一句话之内了。
But the whole law is fulfilled in one word. You shall love your neighbor as yourself.
这一节圣经的直译应该是全律法都在一句话里面得到成全就是爱你的邻舍如同自己。
The direct translation of this verse is all laws are fulfilled in one word. That is, love your neighbor as yourself.
成全律法。
To fulfill the law.
难道保罗要求基督徒要在律法之下遵守律法吗?
Does Paul want Christians to obey the law?
难道他忘记了他在加拉太书里面讲了这么多的教导?
Didn't he forget that he has taught so much in the book of Galatians?
他清楚地说过我们向律法是死的并且已经在律法之下得到了释放。
He already said, towards the law, we are dead and we are set free from the law.
成全律法不是要求我们要遵守律法。
It is not a requirement for us to obey the law.
成全律法乃是在描述一个基督徒做爱的奴仆以后会活出来的样子。
It is a description of a Christian life after he chooses to become a slave of love.
当一个基督徒被基督的爱充满蛮有信心的去爱他的邻舍的时候。
When a Christian is filled with faith and he is willing to love his neighbor,
他所表现出来的就是律法上所有的要求。
The outer experience of this person will be just the same as what the law requires.
或许有人会问。
Or some people will ask,
耶稣在马太福音曾经说过
In book of Matthew, Lord Jesus once said
在22章37节那里。
In chapter 22, verse 37.
一直到第40节。
Until verse 40.
简单的说就是整个律法其实有两部分的。
To be simply saying, all the laws has two parts.
一个是爱神。
One is to love God.
一个是爱人。
The other one is to love,
邻舍,
to love your neighbor.
那保罗为什么只讲爱邻舍不讲爱神呢?
And why Paul only mentioned to love your neighbor, but did not mention the part that says to love God?
约翰在约翰一书四章二十节和二十一节替我们回答了这个问题。
The Apostle John answered this question for us in his letter, 1 John chapter 4, verse 20 and 21.
人若说我爱神，却恨他的弟兄，就是说谎话。
If anyone says, I love God, and hates his brothers, he is a liar.
不爱他所看见的弟兄，就不能爱没有看见的神。
For he who does not love his brother who has seen cannot love God who he has not seen.
爱神的也当爱弟兄，这是我们从神所受的命令。
And this commandment we have from him, whoever loves God must also love his brother.
我们都知道爱神是里面的心态。
We all know that to love God is our attitude within.
外面不容易看出来的。
It is not easy for us to see from our appearance.
爱人，那主要容易从外表看得出来。
But to love your neighbor, it is very easy to see.
如果一个人真的里面有爱神的心，
If someone truly has a heart to love God,
他外面爱人是非常容易的。
It will be easy for him to love his neighbors in actions.
神命令我们爱我们的邻舍。
God commanded us to love our neighbors.
这里的爱不是感觉或者是情感上的爱。
The love that mentions here is not an emotional love,or a love of feeling.
这里的爱是意志上的爱。
This is a love of will.
爱我们的邻舍。
To love our neighbors.
它最关键的点是什么呢?
The most critical point of this truth.
在好撒玛利亚人的比喻里面。
And we can see this from the parables of the Good Samaritan.
就看得很清楚。
We can see it clearly.
基本上就是别人的事情你要放在心上。
Basically, it thinks you have to care about other people's matter.
或者是保罗在其他的地方讲到说看别人比自己强。
Or just as what Paul says in the book of Philippians, you have to see other people are better than ourselves.
我们每一个基督徒都需要常常省察自己。
For all Christians, we should very often examine ourselves.
我是不是一个单顾自己的人?
Am I someone who only cares about myself?
我如果是一个单顾自己的人,
If I'm a person who only cares about myself,
我是没有自由的。
Then I don't have freedom.
因为我是我肉体的奴隶。
Because I am a slave of my flesh.
那我们怎么办呢?
Then what should we do?
如果我们发现自己爱心冷淡,
If we see we don't really have much love,
不是我们下了决心,
It is not that we can just make up our mind.
或者勉强我们自己就可以改变的,
Or force ourselves to change the situation.
我们需要重新回到主的面前。
We should come back to the face of our Lord.
我们需要被神的爱充满。
We need to be filled with the love of God.
我们需要更多的认识我们的主。
We should know more about our Lord.
爱心冷淡是因为我们的信心出了问题。
It is because our faith has some problem, then we lose our love.
我们每一个人都要记住。
Every one of us should remember.
今天我们觉得很多很重要的事情。
Many things we think it is so important today.
要不了多少年以后，你就发现其实都算不得什么。
It won't take too long. We won't value them anymore.
也没有什么永恒的价值。
Not saying it is, they don't really have any eternal values.
我相信我们中间还有一些人记得。
I believe that some of us will remember.
唯有生发爱心的信心才算得数。
Only the faith that brings forth love will have eternal value.
那个才有永恒的价值。
It has eternal value.
总而言之，
As a summary, in conclusion,
今天的经文基本上就是告诉我们
The scriptures we read today tells us
自由是神所赐给我们的
Freedom is granted by God
非常的宝贵
It is so precious
没有人可以剥夺我们的自由
No one should be able to take away
我们要珍惜
We should treasure
我们也要尊重别人
We should respect other people's freedom too.
自由有一个极大的仇敌。
The freedom has a greatest enemy.
那就是我们的肉体。
That is our flesh.
神给了我们自由。
God granted us freedom.
是为着让我们可以用我们的自由选择做。爱的奴仆
It's for us to choose to become a slave of love using the freedom that granted by God.
因为当我们可以自由地去爱的时候
When we are able to love freely,
我们就能够彰显神的爱
Then we can manifest the love of God.
我们能够享受神的爱
Then we can enjoy and appreciate the love of God.
我们就是一个真自由的人了。
And we are people with true freedom.
我们低头祷告。
Let's bow our heads and have some prayer.
天父，我们把你的话交在你的手上。
Heavenly Father, we commit your words into your hand.
求圣灵用着这些话祝福你自己的百姓。
May the Holy Spirit use these words to bless your people.
让你的百姓脱离一切的律法主义。
So that your people will be set free from all legalism.
也让你的百姓脱离一切肉体的缠累。
And your people will be set free from the bondage of your flesh.
我们能够在爱中自由地来服侍。
So that we can serve one another in love, freely.
当我们越服侍别人的时候。
The more we serve others.
我们就更多地被你成全。
The more we are accomplished by you, edified by you.
我们就能够更多地彰显你的荣耀。
And the more we can manifest your glory.
求你听我们这样的祷告。
Please listen to our prayer.
奉主耶稣基督宝贝的名。
In the precious name of Jesus Christ.
Amen. 神祝福你们。
God bless you all.
好，弟兄姐妹。